If invoice reconciliation is your least favorite part of the job, you are not alone. But what if ChatGPT writes up and running VBA macro code for you to automate your invoice reconciliation process? My name is Kailash, and in this video, we are going to talk about how you should design a structured prompt for ChatGPT to generate working code in just one response. But before that, I request you to subscribe to our channel and tell us in comments how did you like this video. All right, let's jump in. So here I have a sample data. And you see this is invoice data. It has got invoice number, amount, status, and found in. And this is what we need to fill. Now how do we fill is this data is a combination of data coming from balance sheet, sales, and HR. Okay, and this also has the amount, and here also we have amount. Now, what we need to do is we need to check each invoice and find if it is there into any of the sheet with the invoice number, followed by, let's say, if it is found, then whether the amount is matching or not. Right? If it is not matching, then we'll type something. If it is matching, then we'll say matched. Okay, now this is we want to do it through VBA macro. Now, what would be our prompt? The prompt would look like something this. Let me expand so that you can see. So we are saying write a VBA macro to insert in the Excel file for the below ask. So master invoice data is available in master sheet. There are three more sheets in the file where department-wise invoices are mentioned. VBA code to take each invoice from master sheet and search by invoice number. If found and amount is also matching, then mention matched in the status column and also mention sheet name, right? And if it is found but amount is not matching, then say amount mismatch. And if it is not found at all, then say not found. And after that, what we have done is we have given sample data. So this is a sample data from master sheet, followed by sample data in finance sheet, sales sheet. Third sheet I have not given because we don't have to give all sheets data. This is just for ChatGPT to understand our data structure. Okay. Now what we'll do is we will copy this and put it in ChatGPT. So here is the ChatGPT. I will paste and press enter. Let's see. So here we have the code. It's still writing. Let's wait. Yeah, invoice matched. Okay, so it is completed and it is also telling how to use it. But we know, being a programmer, we know how to use it. So we'll just copy, go to our Excel file and use Alt F11 to go inside the VBA code. Then insert a module here and paste the code. Shall we run it? Let's see. Okay, it has run. And what is the result? Let's have a look. So it is telling that this invoice is matched and found in finance sheet. If we go to this, yes, it is here, right? Same way it is doing. Let's see. It says amount mismatch. Right, so it found it in HR sheet. So if I go here, here it is 400, and what is here 450. Yeah, the amount is mismatched, right? And this it was not able to find. And let's try to create some scenario and let's see if it works or not. Rather than going to the code window, I'll insert a shape. Insert shapes. Okay. I'll say reconcile data and make some formatting. This is looks good. Increase the font and assign the macro. Where is our macro? Assign macro. Invoice matches, right? Now let's click. You see, it says it is able to find, but the amount got mismatched. Same way, like this, not found. Now, you see that in just one response, we got the working code, right? Now, this prompt, we have designed it into three different portions. And let's see what it contains. So the first line of code, which is write a VBA macro to insert an Excel file for below us. This is where we are telling that we need a VBA code. Okay, don't give me anything here. Just I need a VBA code that I need to use it in my Excel, right? And then very detailed and informative, logical way, we have mentioned this instruction that what our requirement is, right? You have given it is pointer wise that this is my sheet structure or the file structure. This is how I want you to put that logic, right? And finally, the sample data. This is required for the GPT to understand your data structure. You may not want to put that entire file, right? Just a sample data is enough. So sample data from master, then sample data from finance, sample data from sales. And not required like everything, but just 2-3 we have given it. And if you do not want to share the live data, you can choose to change some numbers and before giving it to ChatGPT, right? And the result was like just 1 second up and running code, right? Hope you like this video. Please do not forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.